29 years of God's miracles.
Hey everybody, what's going on? TBN viewers, we want to welcome you. We are actually here backstage. I'm here with my beautiful co-host, Mrs. Lisa Kimmey. I'm T-Bone. Today we're going to be talking to some of the biggest names in Christian music. So we're here at the Dove Awards. So listen, guys, we want you guys to stay tuned.
Everybody get ready. Lights, camera, action. You've tuned in to the number one show on TBN.
Real video.
With real flows and pros that can rock pros with afros and kangos or as headbangers. Long-haired skaters, we the show with the answers to your problems like calculators. Whether rock, ska, hip-hop, punk, or pop, it don't matter. We got funk to bump every block. So be sure to tune in. Make no assuming, we got the best selection of Christian videos for your viewing.
Pleasure.
To bless ya.
Whether in Russia,
Asia, North or South America. What?
If that meant that I could count on you to give me everything.
Hey everybody, welcome back. We're here backstage right now with one of the hottest groups in Christian music. They off the Higgado. We're here with my people's Jars of Clay. How y'all feeling?
Great.
Awesome.
Feeling great.
Awesome, man. You having a good time?
Man, we're making it happen out here. Having fun.
Sweet. Now tell us what you're doing here at the Dove Awards today.
Man, just we're not winning any doves, but that's fine. We were up for one. We didn't win, but we performed a song, I Need You, tonight. Awesome. Had a blast. You know,
and this is your second, third time performing here?
Third.
I think it is the third.
Man, you know, you get old, you start forgetting.
Now tell us a little bit about your project. What have you guys been doing lately? What's going on with the music?
Just released 11th Hour, which is our new album, released in March. We did a pay-per-view event.
Awesome.
It was just music, no wrestling, no steel cages. It was just us and the music, and I think that's still available to order, and we're doing a DVD in August. So.
Sweet. Well, let me ask you guys this. What's in the future as far as a group for Jars of Clay? What can people expect in the future? More records, more videos, more what? Is there anything you guys are doing besides music?
Fast food restaurants.
Yeah, we're
going to
open up the Jars of
Chicken.
Jars of Chicken.
McDonald's.
We're going to open up a crazy chicken. Or a chicken crazy. We're going to open up a chicken crazy.
All right, man. Well, listen, guys. Thank you guys for coming on. This is T-Bone here, Jars of Clay, backstage at the Dove Awards. Everybody throw the peace sign up. One love. We'll see you right after this.
Hey, what's up? I'm back here backstage with Skillet. Will you guys do us a favor and introduce yourselves? I know you, but...
I am Corey Cooper.
Hi, I'm Ben.
Lori.
John Cooper.
I have to tell you, I was watching you guys, and you're, like, such a comedian. It was so great. Were you nervous at all? Was that your...
I think I was a little bit nervous beforehand, and then once I got up there, I was just like, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, I'm always making jokes, and nobody ever usually laughs. In our concert, usually people are sitting there staring at us, and I'm always like, what's up? What's up?
That's me. Well, will you tell the people what you guys got going on, what's new for Skillet, and what's
sure.
going on?
Sure. Well, this isn't necessarily the first thing, but Corey and I are married, and we're going to have our first baby this year.
Awesome. Congratulations.
So that's one thing going
Congratulations.
On. We're very excited. In October, that is. So she's not showing yet. But she will be soon.
Oh, awesome.
So that's exciting.
She's a new mommy.
Look how she's all smiling. Yeah, tummy.
There's a baby in there.
And
so I'm assuming this is going to be the coolest dressed kid ever. You know, if you can see what she's got going on, this kid is going to be pretty hot.
We appreciate that. We'll see that.
And you and the dad makes clothes.
I do, actually.
Yes.
I've got a small clothing line. And I like
which
it.
Is?
It's called invincibleware.com.
Invincible
not invisible wear.
Okay.
Because that would be gross. Invincible.
That would not be very
no,
Christian.
We don't do that.
Okay.
But other than that, we were on an Alien Youth tour, and we just had a great time. We've been seeing loads of people get saved on this
awesome,
tour. And
awesome.
I'm not just being an evangelist.
Whatever.
I'm we're telling you, it's been awesome.
That's great. Well, thank you guys so much for coming back and
yeah,
talking to
yeah,
me.
Thanks.
I appreciate it.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. Backstage, I'm here with my man, the man, Mr. Kirk Franklin. How you feeling, baby?
Heezy, for sheezy, up in the holy peasy.
Off the Higgado, right?
Tibbezy.
How you feeling, my man? You looking good. You looking good.
Love is God, man.
That's it. Well, man, you had an awesome performance today. Tell us what you're doing here and what's going on.
Oh, man, well, I'm just trying to represent for the saints that are a little, you know, tanned. You know? You know, just continually just trying to break that color wall down, you know.
Right.
You know, just trying to race it so we can get the body popping.
That's it, my man. And Kirk, you've opened up so many doors. I actually had the privilege of doing the Latin American Music Awards together. That was crazy.
And he's blasted. He came in heated like the 4th of July in Houston, Texas.
We just try to keep it cracking like pistachios, my man. You feel me? Kirk, what's going on? Tell us about the project and what's going on with that. Are you on tour? What's going on with Kirk right now?
Well, I'm just praying about the next step. You know, the album is out. It's called The Rebirth of Kirk Franklin. And, you know, it's just a personal piece and just whatever God want to breathe on it, you know, that I'm just available. But, you know, just one day at a time, just seeking the Father's heart. That's what I'm doing.
Well, Kirk, man, we appreciate you coming on. We know you're a busy man. So do your thing, my man. He's making moves.
Y'all
like
filling him with hair? Y'all filling him with hair? We need to write in. We need for you to call us right now. And we need to do a poll. Do we feel T-Bone with hair or without hair?
Trust me.
Everybody, welcome back. It's me and Lisa again. And Lisa, who do we have
I'm
with
so
us right
excited.
Now?
I'm excited. We have my favorite Christian, my favorite vocalist, period, of all
period.
Time. Crystal Lewis. No,
Crystal,
seriously.
How are you doing, girl?
I'm doing fine.
Now, real quick, tell us a little bit about your label, Metro One, which is dear to my heart because a lot of people may not know Metro One was actually the label that enabled me to get my start. I wouldn't even be here today if it wasn't for Metro One and for Brian and Crystal putting a label together and saying, you know what, we want to make some great Christian music. What is that like and how's all that going?
It's going great. This is our 10th year this year. I cannot
yes.
believe it's been that long.
Wow.
But we have some great artists on our label. We had a great band named Spoken. They just left. But I'm on the label. And great guy by the name of Dickie Ochoa. We have a new band called Juggernauts and just some really fun stuff.
Way too long.
Wait a minute. We've been talking
seriously for too long now. It's time to take this interview over. How you doing, T-Bone?
What's going on, my man? What's bubbling? It's all great. It's all great. Plus one is up in the hizzle, my man.
Good to see you.
How you doing, my man? Good to see you. What's going on? And man, I feel like I just got bombarded over here. I just seen all this hair coming at me. I'm like, who? It's gotta be plus one.
I like cornrows, man.
Hey, I'm trying to do some new things.
We gotta talk about the outfits. We have to talk about the style. Like, where do you guys get? No, you guys are always so fly. You always look so great. Like, what is your inspiration? Where do you get that from?
A band called The Strokes. I don't know. We like to shop at thrift stores. Last year we spent a whole bunch of money, so this year we're broke. So we decided to go to the thrift stores to buy our outfits.
You know,
so.
And I like that. My man represents some Cali love. He got the Chuck Taylors on, so it's all gravy.
This is Hollywood. Jeremy, a.k.a. Hollywood.
Mr. Hollywood is in the house, ladies and gentlemen. So right now what we're going to do, how you doing? I love the new hairdo. It looks great, my man. Off the Higado, for real. He got the Vans on. I mean, the man is just in style. What we want you guys to do real quick is we want you guys just to sing something. And Crystal, you can just ad-lib. She's just with her bad self. So I'm going to let y'all take over.
All right, what do you want to sing?
Forever?
She's just going to ad-lib, and she's going to add some seasoning.
Okay.
I don't care.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I don't care what it takes. I don't care who it shakes. I don't care what they say. I'm going to do it your way. Even if I'm afraid, don't want to make you look fake. I don't care about anything. It's not about me.
Yeah.
Cheer up, my brother, and live in the sunlight, and we'll understand in by and by.
Awesome, Crystal. Awesome.
Everything is different now. Look at me and you can see I changed somehow. You might think it's strange the way I hold it down, but I know, hey, you know, I got what you need. My life is different now. Look at you and I can see you're wondering how. Though you think it's strange the way I hold it down, no, I know, hey, you know, I got what you need.
Only 11, but he climbed to the top with outstretched arms and he screamed at the top of his lungs.
Move out my way, give up the fight. Next to me is extremely tight. Living up in me, like it or not. Put an axe on my chest, cause X marks the spot. We're living in the keys are extreme.
Hey, everybody, welcome back. Lisa and T-Bone backstage here with the one and only Mr. Toby Mac, baby. How you feeling?
I'm surrounded by beauty right now, you know what I mean? Especially to my right, you know, yeah, I know.
Now, listen, we're trying to do a little blank thing, you know, it's all gravy. But listen, my man, right now, actually, history just took place. My man Toby just won Producer of the Year. Can you tell us about what that feels like? I mean, so many other people have won for, you know, years and years and years, and it seems like finally somebody that's on the cutting edge, somebody that's really doing some big things and doing stuff that young people can relate to, actually won an award. Can you tell us what that feels like?
You know what? If I remember 95 when DC Talk, Jesus Freak won Song of the Year, and it just freaked everybody out, because after that it was all AC songs. Right. It reminds me of that, because, I mean, you know, most of, I produced a couple other things on the side, but most of the production work I did this last year was my record, Momentum, right, which really is a big statement. I mean, Producer of the Year really produced a urban pop record, right, you know what I'm saying? Right. So it's like, that's a big statement, and I'm proud for that reason more than anything else.
Well, Toby making some serious moves, like some U-Haul trucks, man. That's real. And Lisa, you was telling us a little bit, you were kind of torn apart, right?
Yeah, well, I was torn three ways, because you were up for the category, you were up for the category, and John Rubin was up for the category. And that's like fam and fam, like all different directions. But since he's responsible, the reason why I'm here, I really secretly in my head was like, Toby, Toby, Toby.
No, Toby, we know this.
As long as we don't have to have any kind of like battle or anything, because if we have like a MC battle, I'm running for the hills on this fool right here.
Now listen, dude, we know this ain't your first one. You sweeping it up tonight, man. Tell everybody what you've won so far.
About to be the Lauryn Hill.
No, Alicia Keys of
rap hip hop dance record, rap hip hop dance song. Which T-Bone, were you up for both?
Yeah.
Man,
it's all good though. Yeah. At least it's in the family.
We still love each other, man. And I actually mentioned him when I got it, because he's been doing it for years, right where they're at.
Tell us, you know, who you're on tour with right now.
I'm touring with a group that's done all right the last few years. And they're really nice girls, man, named Out of Eden.
Okay.
And then John Rubin.
Sweet, sweet, sweet. So you tell us, Lisa, what's it like being on tour with your boss?
Well,
honestly,
I'm not her boss. Trust me, this girl's a diva. She runs things.
That's not, I cannot believe you just said that. No, actually, it is awesome. Like I tell people always ask us what it's like, and it's just amazing, because Toby, even though you're so massive, like in here, he's, you know, he just doesn't have a big head, you know.
He's got big hair, but not big head, right?
Don't start getting, but it's just fun. Like on the tour, John, Toby, it's just love. It's all love.
He got extensions.
All right. This is real, baby. Toby, listen, man, we thank you for being on the show, and we're excited about what God is doing, and keep going, my man. All hopefully right. You win some more in the future, just not against me.
Adore, Jesus, I adore you, and I lay my life before you.
Hey everybody, what's going on? This is T-Bone and Lisa. We're here backstage with the one and only Jackie Velasquez. How you doing, baby girl?
I'm wonderful. I'm just hanging out.
Just hanging out?
Well, you know.
So yeah. Tell tell us.
Well, just hanging out, you know, I'm watching everybody. Everyone is having so much fun and looks beautiful, and it's just definitely a low-key kind of year for me. Thank goodness.
Well, I think you're one of the most beautiful things around here right now. I just happen to be standing next to two beautiful ladies, but I see you have a Dove Award in your hand. Yeah. Can you tell us what you won today?
I won for Spanish Language Album of the Year.
Awesome.
How do you feel about that?
You know, I feel very, I feel blessed. I have to say, I'm very proud of my Latin people. You know, everybody that was nominated, I feel very proud that they have a category for Spanish Language Album of the Year, and I feel very proud of the fact that there's so much talent within the Latin market, so much talent, and I'm just blessed to get to be able to be a part of it.
Awesome. Well, listen, our show goes into Latin America. Si es que la gente que está viendo esto aquí, que habla español, hay algo que tú quieres decir para la gente que está ahorita viendo este programa.
Solamente muchísimas gracias por todo. Y ojalá que puedo verle todos ustedes muy pronto. Y ojalá que usted le guste mi disco.
Lisa, anything you want to say?
Whatever she said.
Day has come and gone. No looking back, I'm moving on.
everybody. What's going on? This is T-Bone and Lisa. We just out here hanging out backstage.
Just
where we at, Lisa?
With my girls at the Dove Awards. Yes.
That's right. Yes. This is Zoe, girl. How you guys doing today?
Good.
You guys having a good time?
Yeah, we are.
Always good to see you guys. And you guys got some big smiles on your face because they're new artists. And this is something me and Lisa never got to win out when we got our first record come out. But we're happy for you guys. Tell them what you won today.
We won New Artist of the Year.
What is it?
It feels cool. It's just a nice gesture when people, you know, when they see what you're doing and say, hey, we approve of what you're doing and we think it's cool.
On behalf of TBN and me and Lisa, we want to congratulate you guys for an awesome, successful year. And we want to thank you guys for being on the show. And you guys keep it locked. Me and Lisa are going to be right back with more of the biggest names in Christian music. It's getting crazy
back here, folks.
Y'all keep it locked right here on TBN. What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. We are here backstage at the Dove Awards. Right now, I'm with one of the hottest groups in Christian music. Y'all just making moves like U-Haul trucks. Y'all keeping it cracking like pistachios. This is the group Mercy Me. How y'all feeling, baby?
We're feeling really good.
Great. Thanks.
Everybody make some noise. Come on. Yeah. It's all good. It's all good. Now, look, man, I'm blinging over here, but I see that you're blinging right here as well, man. Y'all doing a lot of blinging right now. Can you tell me what you guys won this year?
We won
some incredible
Pop contemporary recorded song or something like that, and Songwriter of the Year and Song of the Year.
That is incredible. So, now, you guys, how long have you guys been together as a group?
8 years.
And is this your first national recording?
Yeah, it is, definitely. Yeah.
But listen, guys, I know that there's a special guest that's here today. There's a young child by the name of Paige. Is that right? Paige, are you here? And I know that you guys actually have granted this a wish come true. How you doing, Paige? God bless you, girl. Paige, let me ask you, what is it like to be able, I mean, for out of all the things you could have wished for, you wish to meet Mercy Me. Why? I don't know. I'm just kidding. They're great guys, but that's what I'm saying. It's incredible. You must really love these guys in order for you to say, this is the one thing I want to do in life. What has it been like to be hanging out with them right now and just to have got to know them?
It's been great. The music tonight was awesome, and just meeting everyone has been really great. And I love their song, I Can Only Imagine, and it's just been really great knowing the stories behind the people that sing it and everything. It's been really cool.
Now, man, I want to ask you something. What does it feel like just to know that, you know, your music has such an impact on kids to the point where they're like, this is a group, this is, if there's anything I could do in life, I want to meet Mercy Me. What does that make you feel like?
Well, I mean, I would turn all these doves in for that feeling. Right. I mean, it's like, The night's been totally overshadowed by Paige, because for anybody to say that is just, it's extremely humbling. And I mean, you know how it is to impact students. And, it's just, I mean, we praise God. It's a little scary because you gotta keep yourself in check because you don't know who's watching.
Right.
But it's just awesome.
You know what? You said something that was vital. You said you would turn all these doves in for something like that. It happened. So why don't you guys give me the doves?
There you go.
And I appreciate it. And you know what? We'll be back. I'm going to go put these things away. We'll be right back.
When you call on Jesus, all things are possible. You can mount on wings like eagles and soar. When you call on Jesus, mountains are gonna fall. 'Cause he'll move heaven and earth to come rescue you. When you call him in the morning, in the
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back. This is T-Bone. We are here backstage right now with three of the biggest names in the world right now. We are here with Nicole Molin, beautiful Nicole Molin. We are here with beautiful Kurt Warner. Yeah, how you feeling today?
I'm doing great.
With Yolanda Adams. How you feeling today, girl?
Awesome. I'm good.
You guys are so awesome. All of you guys have done such an incredible job today. Nicole. Lisa's not here. She's been with me on the show the whole entire time.
I love Lisa.
And that's right.
Girl,
okay. Nicole, listen, today you were incredible. You won 2 Dove Awards. Tell everybody what you were up for today and what you won.
I think short video and female vocalist.
Awesome. Now, Kurt, you are just, I mean, people just love you. You're so, and you know what I appreciate about you? You're such an awesome testimony for Jesus.
Well, thank you.
I mean, when the Super Bowl was won, the first person you acknowledged was Christ. And you know what? I just want to tell you that that's awesome. And
well, I appreciate it.
Yeah, we want to know what you've been up to. And I didn't know that you could host so well. You did a great job today at the Dove Awards.
I didn't know either. That was kind of just on the fly. But, you know, I just realized that the Lord's given me an amazing platform and that I'm going to use it to the utmost. It's going to be short-lived. I'm not going to be playing football forever. And not very often do you get in front of 100 million people and get a chance to praise the name of God. So I just thank the Lord every day for where he's placed me and what he's given me a chance to do. And this Dove Awards was another opportunity to do something a little bit out of my comfort zone, but I just let him take over. And I get a lot of things going on in the offseason. I get a lot of opportunities to speak, to share the gospel, to do things like this. But obviously my main goal is to get back to the Super Bowl, and I'm working towards that right now.
So what's going on right now? What are you doing right now? What's going on for Kirk these days?
Well, right now we're going through our workouts. We're getting ready to start practice here pretty soon, so I'm doing that. And like I said, I'm getting an opportunity to go out and speak. I like to do it a lot in the offseason. Minister with my family. I've got my own foundation. Last week, I was able to take part in a Teen Mania Acquire the Fire event where I spoke to 55,000 kids that are on fire for God. And that's the kind of stuff that I'm just blessed to be able to do with the position that I've been given. And I'm just trying to take advantage of all I can.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And right here to my left is another incredible person who I am so blessed because I got to do a duet with you. People are like, wait a minute, a duet with a rapper and a singer? Nicole, why are you laughing, girl?
Nothing. I ain't laughing. I know what's all that.
We are here with Yolanda Adams.
Now,
how you
really
doing, girl?
You have to tell them where we first met. Remember, we were in
Florida. Okay, let me break it down. We were in Florida, and we were at a
rodeo.
Place. A rodeo that seated about probably like 5,000-10,000 people, and the promoter.
Stinky.
It was stinky, and the promoter didn't do his job because
and
there was hardly anybody
there.
So we go way back. Now, what have you been up to, girl? That you've been doing so many things. You won Grammys this year. I mean, every award pretty much that you could win. What's been going on?
Well, you know, you and I got a chance to work out our cool thing on Believe, and that's what's happening right now. We're trying to make sure that Believe stays on the charts and continues to bless people. We're working on another video for Believe. Hopefully, it'll be thankful. You know, I'm thankful.
You know what a lot of people saying? They want to hear that. And
they need to.
They need
but they need to see you and me on a video.
On a video, just working it out like we at the gym, right? We just trying to make moves like U-Haul trucks. Am I right?
Hey, hello.
So listen, also, I know another great thing that you got to do this year, and being that Kirk is here, you guys actually, you sang at the Super Bowl. What was that like?
I got a chance to sing at the Super Bowl with folks like Patti LaBelle, James Ingram, Barry Manilow, and Winona Judd. My goodness, don't you know? First of all, I am a total football fan, okay? And, you know, I'm not just saying it because Kurt was here, you know, and, you know, we've been hanging out this weekend. I was rooting for him like nobody's business. I was like, yes, go. And, you know, I'm really, really happy. But, you know, also to see so many people just come together and you know, sing for the purpose of healing the nation, because that's what that song was really about. You know, let freedom ring.
Whoa, what happened? Did the rapture happen? I know the rapture didn't happen because that's right. As you guys can see, Kurt Warner and Yolanda are gone. They had to run out of here, but I still have the beautiful Nicole Mullen with me. How you doing, girl?
Great.
Listen, man, it's been an exciting year for you. You've been doing such great things. And you know what? We're getting ready to close the show. We've had such a great time. We got to speak to a lot of the biggest names in Christian and gospel music, such as yourself. And you know what? What I want you to do, Nicole, is there's a lot of kids that watch this show and a lot of adults and young people. And I just want you to share whatever's on your heart. Is there anything that you want to share with them?
Yep. You know what? 1 Timothy 4:12 says, don't let anybody look down on you because you're young. Don't give them a cause. But you set an example for the believer in speech, in life, in love, in faith, and in purity. Go out and do it.
Hey, everybody, what's going on? This is T-Bone, and this is my beautiful host.
Aw, thank you. I'm Lisa.
That's right. And listen, Lisa, we've had a great time. We got to talk to all kinds of groups. Listen, guys, as always, we want to hear from you guys what you guys think about the show. Let us know what you thought. The address is on your screen. But, Lisa, before we go, as always, we want to be able to send a message to the kids that are watching. There's a lot of kids that are watching the show right now. And I just want you to share some words of encouragement right now to some of those kids that are out there watching.
You know what, T, as out of Eden, you know, God has just impressed upon our hearts the need to let people know that God has a destiny for their life. You know, they've labeled our generation hopeless, Generation X.
right.
But that is not true, because the Bible says in Jeremiah 29:11, I know the plans that I have for you, plans to give you a hope and a future that will not be cut off. So I want you guys to stay encouraged and know that God has given you a destiny. He's got plans for you, and he's going to do great things in your life. Stay
That's
encouraged.
Awesome. Lisa, it's been such a pleasure doing this
show
with you.
Thank you.
It's kind of sad that we got a breakup, so we love you guys. We encourage you guys to stay tuned, and we'll see you guys soon. And we're going to be doing a show with Adam Eden, so you guys do want to keep it locked right here. We'll see you guys next time right here on Real Videos.
God bless you.
Bye-bye.
This is the Trinity Broadcasting Network.